Hi, Nick Collier here, and this is my shop. Come join me. We'll have some fun.
Hey, YouTube. Nick Collier here. Just getting over that flu that's been going around, and still got a little bit of congestion, but hey, I'm back in my shop. Yippee! And this project, maybe you recognize it, came in about 3 weeks ago, a month ago. I turned this down for this guy. And now he sent it back and he wants me to do the next step. So basically the next step is a thrust washer, a roller bearing, a spacer, another roller bearing, a thrust washer, and a nut. And he wants me to drill a hole in the nut through the shaft and put a cotter pin in there. And then he also wants to make these bearings. I'll show you the other side. You can see there's a whole set of roller bearings, needle bearings inside of that. So we're going to build a sleeve to go on top of the roller bearing and to this size. So we've got four sleeves, three, four, and then we've got a spacer, and then he wants me to cut this down just a little further to adjust to the width of all of the these pieces here. So it looks pretty simple. We'll get started and see what we can do. All right, first thing we're gonna do is, I've got these two little short plugs of 8620. We're gonna drill holes through the center of them and then bore them out to fit the sleeve. Now I've already drilled a about a quarter inch hole in through this first piece of slug. And then we're going to come back with a, I believe it's a 5/8, and finish that hole off, and then go ahead and bore it. We need to come back and bore it, but first we're going to take two, hang on a second here. We're going to take two slugs off of this piece of material, so I want to get this out so I can get the two slugs off. And each slug is 3/4 inch, so we're looking at 1.5 inches. So there's 1.5 inches, basically. I think we've got plenty of room, well, plus the bit. So let's take it to 1.6 inches. We still have plenty of room. We're gonna bring it out to there. We might even just take it in just a little bit. Let's see what we got. A little bit off. We're gonna bump it in. Because we're almost to size. We're within about 20 thousandths of size, and I need to have that pretty close in order to get it. So I think what I'm gonna do is go ahead and put the forejaw in there and work it from there. So we'll come back after we get the forger.
Okay, so we've got the forger in, we've got it centered, and we're now going in and pouring the inside at about 10 at a time. 10 on each side, of course. Now we'll take a measurement. So we've got 662, and we need to go to 686. Or actually 685, because we want a press fit. So we've got, 20 more thousandths. Or so. We're going to take it five at a time, or, five on each side, just to kind of get the spring tension used to the hole, so that when we take that last cut, it's exactly the same tension on the shaft. So we got 675 right now. One thing I want to do is I want to come in with, he wants me to surface grind this outside surface. So I want to come in with the surface grinder and see if I can get in, how close I can get in here. Yeah, not a problem. Well, we still got a long way to go, but I want to start taking more accurate measurements at this point. Seventy-six and a half. And what did we need to go to? There's 86. So we need about 15. There's 5, 10,
I'm saying 12 thousandths. So that's six on each side. We're gonna take five and come back in with a spring cut. Looks good. We're sitting at 685, and our size is 690, 689. Jesus. It's out around 689 to 690. So let's just say 689. And what was our size again? 685. So if we took five off, we would be good. I'm going to do a spring cut just to see what it looks like. Yeah, that could be the five right there. Damn it, it took too much. All right, well, it is what it is. Well, I don't know. There's a bit of a taper on that, so it presses in nicely right there. I mean, it's a finger press, but it does press. And as it goes further in, it presses. I think we might be able to pull it off. We'll cut the last quarter inch off of here, and then by the time it gets in here, it's a press fit. But what I have to do now is get that bearing back up.
Okay, so our outside measurement .235, and we are sitting at 265 right here. So we'll be able to get that rust off of there, and I think we'll be able to, we'll be in good shape. And since this is 8620, I'm coming in with a insert, because that thing's going to take a bit of a pounding by the time we get to the end. Okay, we're sitting at 1, 2, 25, 35, 38. All right, well, that other piece, I couldn't get under the rust without making it too small. So we're gonna start again with a whole new piece of material, and this time we're gonna be able to take all four segments out of it at one time. Okay, so at this point, we've got a basic hole drilled. It's pretty hot. So what I want to do is I want to take just a skim pass along here and see if we have a taper going. So we have a 1/1000th taper in that distance. I think it's something we can live with, at least for this project. Okay, we got our surface grinder hooked up. We are gonna run a nice smooth surface over the top of this and take off about 5/1000ths. So let's make a first run and just see what we've got.